Feast of Corpus Christi. Cibam Deus et sanctum Petro menti, alleluia, et in petra mella saturabiteus, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Exultati Deo adjutori nostra, jubilati Deo viato, gloria Patri, Filii, Spiritui Sancta, sicur erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum, amen. Cibam Deus et sanctum Petro menti, alleluia, et in petra mella saturabiteus, alleluia, alleluia. Gloria in excelsis Deus, et pax dominibus bonae voluntatis. Laudamus te benedictimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te. Gratias agimus tibi propter magnum gloriam tuam. Domine Deus, ex Deus pater omnipotens. Domine Filii unigenite Iesu Christe. Domine Deus Sanctus Dei Filius Patris, vitalis peccata mundi miserere nobis, vitalis peccata mundi suscipe deprecationem nostra, qui sedes in extrem partis miserere nobis, quoniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus dominus, tu solus artissimus Iesu Christe, cum sancto spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Dominus vobis et cum spiritu tuo. Oremus. Deus qui nobis in sacramento mirabili passionis tui memoriam nere Christi, tibum et quaesum ans inter nos corporis et sanguinis tui sacra mysteria venerari, fidentiamus tui fructum in nobis utit essentiamus, qui vivis et regnis in Deo Pater unitatis Spiritus Sancti Deus per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lectio Epistolae Beati Pauli Apostoli a Corinthios. Brethren, I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread and giving thanks, broke and said, Take ye and eat, this is my body which shall be delivered for you. This do for the commemoration of me. In like manner also the chalice after he had supped, saying, This chalice is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you shall drink for the commemoration of me. For as often as you shall eat this bread and drink this chalice, you shall show the death of the Lord until he come. Therefore, whosoever shall eat this bread or drink of the chalice of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man prove himself, and so let him eat of that bread and drink of the chalice. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily, eateth and drinketh judgment to himself, not discerning the body of the Lord.
Erratus.
Oculi omnium tesper, domine tu, das ibises camera tempore opportunum. Aperis tu manut tuam, et impes omne anima benedictionem. Alleluia, alleluia, caro meo veres, cibus et sanctus mei veres est potus. Qui manducat meum carnem et bibit meum sanguinem, in me manet et ego in eum. Laudat eum salvatorem, laudat lucem et pastorem, in ignis infantigis. Quantum potes, tantum arde, quia maior omni laude, nec laudare sufficis. Laudis terra specialis, panis fumis et vitalis, hodie proponitur. Quem in sacre mense cene turbe tractum duodene datum non ambitum. Sit las plenas, sit sonores et jucundas, sit decor mentis jubilatio. Dies erem somnes agito in quam mense prima recolito plus institutio. In hac mensa novi regis novum pasca nove legis fase vetus peria. Vetus statum novitas, umbram fugit veritas, noctem lux eliminat. Quod in cena Christus jesit, faciem cum hoc expressit in sui memoriam. Docti sacris institutis panem vinum in salutis consecramus hostiam. Domino dato Christianis quod in canent antipanis et vinum in sanguine. Quod non capis, quod non vides, animos affirmat vides, preter erum ordine. Sub diversis speciebus sinis tantum et non rebus latent res eximie. Caro cibus sanguis potus manit tamen Christus totus sub utraque specie. Assumente non concisus, non confractus, non divisus integer accipitur. Sumut unus, sumut mille, quantum iste tantum mille nec sumtus cum sumitur. Sumut boni, sumut mali, sorte tamen inequali vitae veri intelitus. Mors et malis vita bonis, vide paris sumcionis, quam sit dispar exitus. Fracto demum sacramento ne vacile sed memento tantum esse sub fragmento, quantum toto tegito. Nulla rei fici sure, sini tantum fit fractura, ne qua nec status nec statura, sini ate minuito. Ecce panis angelorum factus cibus aviatorum, vere panis filiorum nomi tendus canibus. In figuris presignato, cum insat immolato, annus pasquae deputato, dato manum patibus, bone pasto panis vere, Iesu nostre miserere, tu nos pasce nos tuere, tu nos bona fac videre in terra vivensium, tu qui cum tascisse vales, qui non tascisse mortales, tuos ibi commensales, coelegis exodales, fac sanctorum civium. Amen. Alleluia. Domino Sulpis. Sequentia Sancti Evangelii, secundum Ioannem.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
At that time, Jesus said to the multitude of the Jews, "My flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He that eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood abideth in me, and I in him. As the living Father hath sent me, and I live by the Father, so he that eateth me, the same also shall live by me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Not as your fathers did eat manna and are dead. He that eateth this bread shall live forever."
Ask ye, Christian.
Today's beautiful feast offers us a possibility of rejoicing and giving thanks to God for the great gift of the holy sacrifice of the Mass and the possibility that we have of receiving Holy Communion. It's a fact which we commemorated on the night of Holy Thursday, but then in a rather more solemn manner, given that on that evening we begin the sacred triduum that marks the liturgical commemoration of the suffering, dying and rising of our Lord. In time there was a great desire to have this opportunity to celebrate perhaps the greatest of sacraments, in that all of our spiritual life is ordered towards the Holy Eucharist. All of the sacraments give grace, but the Holy Eucharist is alone in giving also the giver of grace. We know that in Holy Communion we are able to receive our Lord, body and blood, soul and divinity. And the beautiful texts of today's Mass, written by St. Thomas Aquinas, were at the prompting of the Pope in 1264, who desired that this feast should be made a universal observance, having its origin in a local feast. Of the many beautiful texts in the Mass, perhaps the most extraordinary is the sequence Lauda Sion, which is the longest sequence in the Roman liturgy. Given the skill of the writer, we shouldn't be surprised that it's a very concise and yet dense account of what we believe, both about the Mass and about Holy Communion. First of all, St. Thomas recognizes that in the Last Supper, our Lord took something which was familiar to the Jews, the Passover meal, which had, by divine ordinance, been an annual commemoration of the exodus from the slavery of Egypt, enabling each successive generation who did not actually experience the exodus to be, as it were, incorporated into that event. He took that ordinance and transformed its meaning. It is still a commemoration of an exodus, but not from the physical slavery of Egypt, but from the far greater and far more harmful slavery of sin and death. We are liberated by Christ's perfect sacrifice, prefigured by the sacrifices, all of them, of the Old Covenant, including the Passover lamb, whose blood was daubed on the lintels of the homes of the people of Israel. All of that prefigures Christ's perfect sacrifice, which is made present to us in the celebration of the Mass across distances,
of time and space, that saving act is present to us and we are present to it in such a way that its power may be effective in us. The second consideration that St. Thomas has in the Laudato is the manner of the reception of communion, that though divided into many, the consecrated bread enables each person who approaches Holy Communion to receive Christ in his totality. He also comments that it is not in itself a guarantee of the worthiness of the recipient. He acknowledges that those who receive it may be good or may be bad, but what he recognizes is the effect of the reception of Holy Communion can be quite different in different people. To a person who receives worthily, it is the promise of heaven and the participation even now in that reality. To a person who's ill-disposed or receiving not in a state of grace, they receive, as St. Paul tells us in today's epistle, they receive to their own judgment. So great is this sacrament in the life of the Church. Perhaps the experience of the last months with restricted access both to the Mass and to Holy Communion stirs up in us a greater hunger and desire for this sacrament. I hope so. I hope that our appreciation is greater than it was 3 months ago. We live in a part of the world where access to the Mass has been, in relative terms, easy. And yet how often we take these things for granted, and it isn't until they're removed as a possibility that we really understand something of the value of what we've had. So we thank God for this great gift of himself. We ask for a greater love and worship of the sacrament of the altar. We ask that we ourselves who are able to receive Holy Communion will always approach the altar worthily and will, in our adoration of Christ made present in our midst, will anticipate something of what we hope to do in eternity, praising God together with all of the saints and angels.
Creator unum Deum Pater omnipotens et Factor in Caeli et Terra, visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Domine Iesum Christum Filium Deum unigenitum, et ex Pater natum ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deo, Lumen de Lumine, Deum Verum de Deo Vero, genitum non factum consubstantiale parti, et cum omnia facta sunt. Qui propter nos omnes et propter nostram salutem, descendit de Caelis, et incarnatus est, et cuique sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. Crucifixus etiam pro nobis sub Pontio Pilato, passus et sepultus est. Et resurrexit etia die secundum scripturas, et ascendit in celum sedet ad dextram partis, et iterum venturis est cum gloria uni pari vivus et mortuus, cuius deni non erit fins, et in spiritum sanctum domino vivificanda, qui ex patre filio per procedet, qui cum patre filio simul adorato con glorificato, qui locutus est per profeta, et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, profitunam baptismam remissionem peccatorum, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum, et vitam venturi saeculi.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo,
oremus. Sancet Doctus Domini, incensum et panis oculum Deo, et idio sancte erus Deus suo, et non poluens nomen Eus. Alleluia.
our sacrificial kindness to its love and glory and now makes you have a good heart and proper nostrum, but we stay place as you suffer.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobis.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Sum corda.
Habemus et Domino.
Gratias agamus Domino Domus.
Dignum et justum est.
Veri dignum et justum est, et cum et salutare. Nos tibi semper et tibique gratias agere. Domine sancte patum de potenza tene Deus, per Christum Dominum nostrum. Per quem mai statum tum laudat angela donatum in externis tum protestantes. Celso runque virtutis of the outer set of insultis of taxone contrary grant. Conquibus et nostra fortis de miti ubius de fidama, superci confessione dice. Sanctus, 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 Domine, secula, secula.
Amen.
Ex Domine,
et cum spirito tuo.
Domine nostrum Dio. Domine nostrum Dio. Domine nostrum Dio.
Misericordiae vestri omnipotens Deus te mystificatis vestris, per duc et vos et vitam eternam.
Amen.
Indulgentiam absolution tua missionem peccatorum nostrum, tum ad vobis omnipotens et misericordiis tuam.
Amen.
Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccata mundi. Domine nostrum dignus et interest protecta men, sed tantum declare quod sanabit anima mea. Domine non sum dignus et interest protectum meam, sed tantum declare quod sanabit anima mea. Domine non sum dignus et interest protectum meam, sed tantum declare quod sanabit anima mea.